Bonjour, WeWave. Here we are with lesson number 2 in the Wave Functions chapter, chapter 12, and we're now looking at other forms. So, if you remember last lesson, we wrote A cos x plus B sin x in the form k cos x minus alpha. However, we can also write this in other forms as well. So we could also write it in the form k cos x plus alpha, or we could have k sin x plus alpha, or even k sin x minus alpha. So let's do a couple of examples. So example 1, write 4 cos x minus 3 sin x in the form k sin x plus alpha for alpha between 0 and 360 degrees. So starting this off the same way, well, if you look here, you have sin x plus alpha. That should be ringing some bells. You should be thinking about the addition formula, and that is what you need to know inside out. Remember, these are given on the formula sheet. So the first thing you want to do is you are wanting to set them equal. So you will say that 4 cos x minus 3 sin x equals cosine x plus alpha. From there, you will then expand this right-hand side. Remember, it's k times, so just put the k and then bracket and expand the sine x plus alpha. If you do that, you end up with sine cos plus cos sine. From there, you will remove the brackets, so you're multiplying by a k. So you have k sine x cos alpha plus k cos x sine alpha. From there, same as last lesson, you want to find the values of k cos alpha and k sine alpha. And to do that, once again, you look at the coefficients. So let's look at the coefficient of cos x. So on the right hand side, we are multiplying cos x by k sine alpha. So we can work out what k sine alpha will be equal to. The coefficient of cos x then, on the left hand side, the coefficient of cos x here is 4. And because the left-hand side equals the right-hand side, you know the coefficients are equal. So the coefficient is k sine alpha, so you know k sine alpha must be equal to this coefficient, which is 4. Do the exact same thing with the coefficients of sine x. So here we've got a sine x, and the coefficient of sine x is k cos alpha. So look at the coefficient of sine x on the left-hand side, and the coefficient of sine x is negative 3. Therefore, we know that k cos alpha is equal to negative 3. Woohoo! After that, what do we do next, Ohana? Brilliant, we find the values of k and alpha. So you can say then that a is equal to k cos alpha and b is equal to k sine alpha, and you want to use them with the formulas that we had in the last lesson. How do we find the value of k? What do we do? Brilliant. That is going to be the square root of a squared plus b squared. So you have the values of a and b. So that will become the square root of negative 3 squared plus 4 squared, which is a square root of 9 add 16, square root of 25, which is 5. So that's us found the value of k. How do we then, Ms. Amel, find the value of alpha? Brilliant. Well done. That's when you have to divide and then set it equal to tan and so on. So last lesson, we learned that k is sine alpha over k cos alpha. You can cancel the k's, leaving you with sine over cos, and sine over cos, as Lewis Kidd said, is equal to tan. And from there, you can then work out alpha. So working that out then, k sine alpha over k cos alpha. Well, k sine alpha is 4, so it's going to be 4 over negative 3. Cancel the k's, sine over cos is tan, so tan alpha is 4 over negative 3. Or negative 4/3. Work out the size of the acute angle, so ignore the negative and just work out tan to the minus 1 of 4/3. If you work that out on the calculator, you end up with 53.1 degrees. Woo! From there, we need to work out the quadrant, so then you're looking about cast and you're thinking about the sines. So here we've got cos, and cos is a negative. Where is cos a negative? Well, it's a negative in S and in T. After that, think about sine. Well, sine is a positive. Where is sine positive? Well, sine's a positive in A and in S. So we've now got two ticks for S. Check that with a third tick. So tan, don't look at tan to the minus 1, look at tan alpha. Tan alpha is negative 4/3. So tan is a negative, and tan is a negative not in A and T, but in the other two, so in C and an S. So you're using the one with three ticks just to triple check that. How would you work it out then? How would you work out the size of the angle if it is an S? What would you do, Liba? Good, it's 180 minus. So it's 180 minus that acute angle, which gives us 126.9 degrees. Writing then for cos x minus 3 sin x in the form k sin x plus alpha, well, we have just found the value of k and we have just found the value of alpha, so we can rewrite that then, replacing k with 5 and alpha with 126.9 degrees. Woo! And that's the answer to that one. Example 2. Write sine x minus root 3 cos x in the form k sine x minus alpha. But once again, we have radians. Ooh. So, you're wanting to start off the exact same way. So we would set equals. So we've got sine x minus root 3 cos x equals k sine x minus alpha. After that, you want to expand. Think about the addition formula. So we've got k sine x minus alpha, ignoring k. Expand sine x minus alpha. Well, sine x minus alpha will become sine x cos alpha minus cos x sine alpha. Again, just put brackets around that, and we'll get a k at the start. From there, multiply out these brackets. So we'd have k sine x cos alpha minus k cos x sine alpha. And once again, from there, you find the values of k cos alpha and k sine alpha. To do this, do it the same way. So let's take the coefficients of cos x and sine x. So the coefficient here of cos x, well, the coefficient of cos x is negative k sine alpha. So we're going to say then that negative k sine alpha equals, and what will that be equal to? We'll look at the coefficient of cos x on the other side. So the coefficient of cos x here is negative root 3. So you know then that negative sine alpha equals negative root 3. From there, if you multiply both sides by negative 1, or change the sign, then k sine alpha equals root 3. We also need to find the value of k cos alpha, so we just took the coefficient of cos, let's take the coefficient of sine x here. So the coefficient of sine x is equal to k cos alpha, so we know then that k cos alpha is going to be equal to, well, the coefficient of sine x on this side, if sine x is just on its own, it means 1 sine x. So you know then that k cos alpha must equal 1. So we have now found the values of a and b. So from there, you're wanting to go through the same stages as we have done in all the other examples. So to find k, it is the square root of a squared plus b squared. So you're using the values 1 and root 3 and subbing them in. So we get the square root of 1 squared plus root 3 squared, where the square root of 1 add 3, which is the square root of 4, which is obviously 2. To find alpha, this is where you're thinking about sine over cos is tan, the k's cancel out, and then you can work out alpha. So k sine alpha over k cos alpha becomes root 3 over 1, which is obviously just root 3. K's cancel out, sine over cos is tan, so tan alpha is root 3. From there, that is one of your exact values. So thinking about the exact value triangles, what's the size of the angle going to be, Aaron? Brilliant, well done. You would get pi over 3, or 60 degrees. From there then, you want to think about the quadrants. Which quadrant will you use this time? Ooh, exciting. So, cos is a positive. Where's cos a positive? Cos is a positive in A for all, and C for cos. Sine is also a positive. Sine is a positive in S, and in A. And tan, well, tan alpha is also a positive, and that is a positive in T for tan, and A for all. Use one with three ticks, which is A. That's the calculator answer. So you can say then that alpha would equal pi over 3. Writing sine x minus root 3 cos x in that form, we have just found the value of k, which is over here. We've just found the value of alpha, which is here. We can sub them in. So that will become 2 sine x minus, and it's the pi over 3. And that will be your answer. Try these questions. They are very similar to that first lesson, only you have other forms here, but the process is the same for each one. Good luck. Let me know if you have any problems. Bye.